for more. Joining us now is Sheila Krumholz, who's the Executive Director for the Center for Responsive Politics, to talk about money in this election cycle. So put 2014 midterm election cycle in perspective. How much money is being raised and spent compared to previous years?
Yes. We've just crunched the numbers and posted this morning a new report showing that we, based on the numbers that have been reported so far, we can confidently project this will be a $4 billion election cycle. Nearly $1 billion of that will come from outside organizations, outside groups, independently spending on behalf of or against candidates. And that really is, I think, the theme of this cycle, is the activity of these outside groups. They make up the largest and growing, fastest growing portion of all of the money, including candidates and parties.
How does that compare to the last non-presidential election cycle, 2010?
Sure. In 2010, the total cost was $3.6 billion. So we're well ahead of that in our projections, and our projections are conservative. We'll be updating them as new reports come in so that we can be sure to be as accurate as possible. $3.6 billion was also about what was spent in the last, in the 2012 congressional elections, excluding all of the spending on presidential. When you look at all of the spending combined, it was a $6.3 billion election in 2012. So shy of that, but that is to be expected.
Who's raising the most money?
Based on our projections, based on the spending so far and what we expect to come in and be spent over the next couple of weeks, it looks like the conservative candidates, GOP candidates, are likely to spend more. Conservative candidates and outside groups are likely to spend more than Democratic and liberal groups, but not by a lot. We're estimating that Team Red will outspend Team Blue $1.9 billion to $1.7 billion. So it's close.
And that could be enough of an edge when you look at some of these key Senate races where it's quite close.
Precisely. And that, I think, is a key factor here. Some people say, many people say, it doesn't seem like a lot of money that is coming in from these outside groups relative to the total cost of all elections. And that, I think, is valid. What's important to remember, though, is that it's being very precisely kind of laser targeted on the most competitive Senate races in particular. And in those races where the vote we know will be close, they have the potential to be determinative. In a matter where votes matter, the money can push it over the edge.
What about political parties and the role that they're playing? How much are they raising and spending, and specifically Democrats, because that's the main role that President Obama is playing this year?
The Democratic Party committees do have a slight edge over the Republican Party committees. I think it is because of the prolific fundraising that President Obama is conducting. He's been out on the hustings and exciting the base and exciting the donors. All told, candidates and parties will spend about $2.7 billion together. But the party edge is not enough to, for the Democrats, is not enough to compete with the conservative outside groups' edge. And their spending is, I think, has in many ways really kind of catapulted over the party. So some have thought that this might be the year where parties would be rejuvenated by the McCutcheon decision, which allows for unlimited aggregate donations from individuals. And there have been major, large donations in the $100,000 or $150,000 range going to party committees and candidates through joint fundraising committees. So it is a different cycle, hard to compare it to 2010 when the rules had changed.
So in the